Born and raised in a Catholic family, she converted to Islam and went on the Hajj to gain a better knowledge of Islamic moral values and of Muslims themselves.
I can't believe it, but I'm here.
O'Leary soon bonded with the Muslims from different cultures, speaking different languages, whom she saw there for the first time, and states that after the Hajj, her faith and devotion to God increased. Furthermore, the joy and honor she feels from being a Muslim is reflected in her words as she describes a conversation with a Muslim she encountered there.
A very happy moment for me was when this large African man helped me find a space, and then he looked at me and said, "American?" And I said, "Yes." He said, "You Muslim?" I said, "Yes." And he said, "Alhamdulillah, praise be to God." And I really felt welcome.
Fidelma O'Leary expresses the unifying effect that the Kaaba and the Hajj have on Muslims in these terms.
All races, all nationalities, all people in one place, concentrated all in one direction, worshiping the one God. This has to be very powerful.
Makkah is described in the Quran as the mother of cities, and the Kaaba, the holiest site for all Muslims. This sacred spot has been bringing Muslims together throughout the history of Islam, and is still doing so today. The way that every year millions of Muslims congregate at the Kaaba and perform their obligations is a valuable source of joy and enthusiasm for all Muslims. That is because all Muslims in the world believe in God and abide by the Quran, follow in the path of our Prophet, turn in the same direction when praying, and hope for the same reward in the hereafter. All Muslims share the same God and prophets, and face in the same direction when praying. No matter what their race, tongue, nationality, or sect, all Muslims are brothers. Muslims must spread the feelings of tolerance and unity they feel through the Hajj at every moment in their lives, draw close to God in a spirit of submission and tolerance, and seek to be of even greater service to His religion. By the will of God, a bright and happy future awaits the Islamic world. In order for that bright future to be built without loss of time, the consolidation of a spirit of alliance, unity, and brotherhood is of the utmost importance. Through the words, "I bequeath you two things, and as long as you cling tightly to these, you will never fall or deviate into error, the Quran and my Sunnah." Our beloved Prophet showed the way to which all Muslims must adhere. Our duty is to cling to that path, and never forget this commandment bestowed upon us by Almighty God. Hold fast to the rope of God altogether, and do not separate. Remember God's blessing to you when you were enemies, and He joined your hearts together so that you became brothers by His blessing. You were on the very brink of a pit of the fire, and He rescued you from it. In this way, God makes His signs clear to you, so that hopefully you will be guided.